gonna start hunting here
at BlouKrans
in the Eastern Cape. And one thing you always do is check your equipment. So I've just been checking my bow for different distances, seeing that it's shooting, you know, where I want it to shoot. So hopefully we have a successful hunt. So this is the biggest of all the spiraled horn antelope in Africa as well. You know, just privileged to take this animal with my bow. This is the grey ghost. This is the Eastern Cape Kudu. They call it the grey ghost because it's a very difficult animal to hunt. It blends into its environment very well. And we're here at BlouKrans and hunting in absolutely pristine area of the Eastern Cape.
So it was a good day of kudu hunting, Alden. Congratulations.
Thank you, and thank you for all your hospitality.
Very, very good shot on this kudu. I'm using some of the latest technology in bow sights, SureSight. SureSight is a bow sight that has an internal range finder, and it actually will automatically set my pin to the distance that I'm shooting. Okay. Equipment is very important, and it's good to use good equipment, and it's very ethical.
And today I'm preparing one of my favorite dishes, which is a traditional South African poiki. Well, I wouldn't say traditional, but my way of doing a poiki. So what I have here is a whole lot of cut up venison. I have potatoes, I have sweet potatoes, bell peppers, onions, and chives, or known as green peppers. What I'm first going to do is I'm going to prep the meat. And typically what I do is I just take a whole lot of my spices, a bit of chili flakes, pink salt, then just a little bit of soya sauce. I'm going to let that sit, and then I'm going to get going. And I've got quite a lot of vegetables to dice, and I'm putting the vegetables in and forming a broth, and then mix it with the meat. There's a bit of coconut oil on the bottom, and don't be shy with this either. Poikis are traditionally cooked on an open fire or over coals. I like to kind of sometimes speed up the process maybe. So I'm going to use the gas stove here just to simmer my onions and a couple of the vegetables while the fire is getting ready. And then I will take the pot out and put it on the fire and leave it there for 4 to 5 hours. So now that the onions are really nicely browned and seasoned, I'm going to throw the meat in and get that browned up. So just add a little bit of water that just helps the broth and everything, you know, cook, and it will thicken up. The sweet potatoes going in, butternut. I'll close that up for a while, and lastly I will add the potatoes. My fire's ready. I know it's not exactly the traditional way to do a poiki, but now I'm going to let it cook slow and for a couple of hours on a really good wood fire, and hopefully we're going to have a great dinner. Potatoes, and now I'm just going to let it cook for hours. Give it a little bit more flavor. No poiki is complete without a good bottle of red wine. Like butter. Just came to check on it. It's definitely ready, and we're going to enjoy a great meal. Another great meal. Another great hunt. Or into a great hunt. Fantastic.